family, friend, a loved one. Light, dark, brown, color, class, we're all remnants of a rape of some sort in this country. Each with unspoken grievances worn internally. But you are still here.
He's a multi-talented actor and filmmaker who is leaving his mark here in Hollywood. And joining us live in the studio is Louis T. Powell, also known as Big Lou, and he's not in the same room with his dad.
That's right. We won't forget your name, Lou.
There you go.
Hey,
Lou.
So you're such a nice guy, great smile, that character. Wow.
That's not like that here.
No, man. It's like it took me into some deep, dark spaces.
So this film, you wrote it, you directed it, and you are an actor in it, obviously.
Yes.
Padlock Men.
Yes.
Tell us about it.
Padlock Men is actually a story about a group of secret vigilante, secret civil rights soldiers from the 60s. Mm. You know, they were doing things non-traditionally. One of their taglines is blood for blood, knuckles dirty. It was like they were the ones who were doing the things outside of the normal traditions of speaking and preaching. You know, it was an eye for an eye, justice. So.
Okay, so you, looking at your IMDb resume, since 2000, you've pretty much steady work. How'd you get into acting?
I got into acting, you know, as a kid, man, I was doing plays, you know, went to Howard University, was in theater, jumped off, and then, you know, I grew up in a barbershop. Mm-hmm. And it's one of those things, you grow up in a barbershop from a real young age, you people watch, you stare, and then people share stories with you over the years. You know, 17 barbers in my family, my father's been doing it like 49 years.
17 barbers?
Yeah.
Wow.
So, you know, the amount of stories that you meet from people that are 60, 70, 80, 90, to your peers, 30, 40, 15 years old, to share those stories, and you get a chance to be basically a voyeur of human experience. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what kind of propelled me into acting, because it was like, you know what, people shared that with me, my own life experience, and being able to go ahead and put that in a form where the camera reads that and reads the emotion.
Got to say, it's a bit of an irony that you grew up in a barbershop.
Yeah.
Just looking at you.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Come on now.
He shaved it
right. Exactly. I did it on purpose.
So, you know, it's interesting because acting is one thing, but you wrote this and directed it. That's takes it to the next level.
Yeah, definitely. You know, writing and directing, I feel like all of his storytelling from acting, writing, and directing, it was one of those things, you know, being able to sit in a space and tell stories as a director and writer and being able to feel the empathy of others and being able to share that in the context as an actor, it was challenging, but at the same time, it was fun. Mm. And it put me in a space where it was cleansing. You know what I mean? Like I said, to be able to share other people's stories, to be able to share my own experiences, you know, growing up in D.C. in the 80s and 90s, and like I said, dealing with these guys, man, that have shared these experiences, and I'm able to express them through written word, and not only through written word, but visually also. It's like a blessing for me, you know, to be able to do that. So
what kind of advice do you have for people that are trying to break into Hollywood?
Hollywood, persistence, and just enjoy the experience. It's like, don't put an end result on the goal. I feel like breaking into Hollywood is like, none of this stuff is real. At the end of the day, it's all make-believe and it's all play. So if you really take that attitude and take it to heart, it's like play. Just go out and have fun. It's like create your heart's content, roll with it, and I feel like doors will start opening up in that direction.
That's great advice. Where can we see this film?
You can actually see it on Amazon Prime. You can check out the pilot teaser. It's actually a basis for a 6-episode limited series that we're developing right now. That you should see over the next couple of years. So,
all right, good for you. Well, you're working hard, following your dreams, and hopefully it'll all come true.
Oh yeah, most definitely.
Yeah. Padlock Men.
Padlock Men.
Okay.
Get available on Amazon Prime.
Yes.